down the scully place. You must respect those staff and STC if you want to stay. You must attend all meetings and meal times soon. Please try to eat all your food. Do you want to have a good week? Then there's gonna be a good week.
No way, Anna.
Taking control past tonight, all day tomorrow, and then when you leave this island, you want him to write his story in your life and guide you every step of the way. If that's the prayer you prayed and you sincerely committed something to Christ, now I want you to stand on your feet, because it's you and God who mean business. Stand up right where you are if that's the decision you made, if that's the prayer you prayed.
When all we know is doubt and fear, there is only one foundation. We believe.
I just pray to God that I'll make better decisions.
One thing that God's really been showing me this week is that we are a bunch of broken people.
Last year, I made a choice to rededicate my life, and it's been a really long year. I've learned so much stuff about myself personally. Like, I've learned that I pretend that I'm okay when I'm not, and I've learned to trust other people and other godly Christians that I'm close to with my problems to help me, because when you bottle that in, all of it in you, it breaks you inside.
It's
me
every now and then, and you just have those fun moments where you're just done and you try to look up and try to talk. And I guess it's through those moments where I feel like I'm at my weakest and I'm at my end point that God can talk to me the most, the point where he can teach me what I never thought I could be taught.
This week, I learned that, especially in quiet time, Even when you don't or you think that nothing is really happening in your life, you have to trust and believe in God that He will do something for you. Not just after the fact, like He will do a miracle in your life and then you pray for that He blessed you or whatever. You have to actually believe that He will do something before it happens so that it will be greater and bigger and your life will turn around.
And I know some people here have already got parents at home who are going to be encouraging you to actually spend time with God and to read your Bibles and stuff. So I'm just encourage you guys, and just remember that it's very important to spend time with God when you're by yourself. Even when you wake up, even if it's listening to some worship music, just taking time to read your Bible, do a devotional.
Everyone is going through like the same thing, but no one wants to admit it because you're all afraid of it. But if you actually were to sit there and admit that something's wrong, chances are you probably got about 5 people around you that are going through the same thing, and you can all help each other and help each other to grow and to get through the thing.
And I think too many times we look at Christ and we think that, oh, that's just something that was a long time ago. No, Jesus is still there with us. He's always there with us. He promised in His word He'll never leave us or forsake us.
Instead of letting that spotlight shine on you, let it shine on Jesus, the greatest treasure in your life, so that everyone can see it. Everyone can see it at this camp and back in your school and in your home. And one day when you have a job and you're working somewhere, let that spotlight shine right on Jesus.
We believe in the crucifixion. We believe that He conquered death. We believe in the resurrection. And He's coming back again. Lost, we found that the dead be raised in the here and now. They love Him, they live in the church, they love. And God will say, we believe, we believe.
You guys, I know that the week is over, but I want you just to continue to be weird for Christ. Remember that the normal life is very easy to live, and I encourage you not to come back next summer and think,
oh, how did I mess up, but that you would come on fire for the Lord next time and be ready to take the next step. Who knows? There may be future SDC people here. So please, take the challenge. If God calls you to that, make that challenge and make that your call.
We had a great time, second week of camp here on Word of Life Island, talking about the miracles of Jesus, the sign miracles of Jesus in the Gospel of John. We started out, remember, talking about Jesus being the revelation of Jesus, of God, full of grace and truth, and how he loves to give his favor to us, and all he wants from us is truth. He's full of grace and full of truth. And then the last thing is Jesus is never late. At the time when he healed Lazarus, he waited 2 days. He's always perfect on time to show his power in your life. So trust him in everything, because he's full of grace and full of truth, and he wants to be that in your life every day of your Christian life.
These Beatitudes were found in the Sermon on the Mount that Jesus preached. And in that Sermon on the Mount, he teaches us how to be more like Christ himself. And what I'd like you to remember from that is that middle beatitude, the one about hungering and thirsting after righteousness. Because that's what you have to do in your Christian life. God promises us that we'll be filled when we hunger and search after righteousness. And so I pray that you'll do that, not by holding on to these messages from this week of camp or any other weeks of camp, but that you'll get into the Bible yourself. Because that's where you find righteousness. It's in the Bible. So get in it, stay in it, and never leave it.